Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to your show, In the Light of the Qur'an. Today, inshallah, we have a new light, a new wisdom that we take from the Qur'an, and we will try to utilize it and make this light shed on our life and give us more light as we get by, as we move forward in our way, in our march towards paradise, towards getting nearer to our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we said, the light that we are trying to get from the Qur'an should all add up, these lights, one on top of the other, should add all together to bring us nearer to Allah, to make us stronger Muslims, so that we follow the example of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so we become real manifestations of the Qur'an walking on earth, or we become Qur'ans walking on earth, so that this light, as we understand it, goes into our hearts and it lights our hearts, then it reflects on our actions, and this light, we can spread it to the people through our conduct, through our behavior, through our character as Muslims, through our actions. And this light, we can spread it to the rest of the world in this way. And inshallah, we should make this one of our main goals in this life. Today's light is very important because it tells us about the wisdom of following the way of Prophet Muhammad and listening to what he says, listening to the injunctions in the Qur'an, following them and being a real Muslim who submits himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will start with the recitation, then we will talk about the meanings and the wisdoms and the light that we can get of it.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تولوا عنه وأنتم تسمعون ولا تكونوا كالذين قالوا سمعنا وهم لا يسمعون إن شر الدواب عند الله الصم البكم الذين لا يعقلون ولو علم الله فيهم خيرا لأسمعهم ولو أسمعهم لتولوا وهم معرضون يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم واعلموا أن الله يحول بين المرء وقلبه وأنه إليه تحشرون واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب واذكروا إذ أنتم قليل مستضعفون في الأرض تخافون أن يتخطفكم الناس فآواكم وأيدكم بنصره ورزقكم من الطيبات لعلكم تشكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون واعلموا أنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة وأن الله عنده أجر عظيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تتقوا الله يجعل لكم فرقانا ويكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويغفر لكم والله ذو الفضل العظيم
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. You know, these wonderful verses from the surah, the Suratul Anfal, is a very wonderful surah. Al-Anfal are the spoils of war. This is the surah of Al-Anfal that we are dealing with. There are so many wisdoms, a lot of advice and instruction that Allah gave us, and really we should try to benefit of that, because there is a lot of light, a lot of life for the heart in these verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, imagine when Allah calls us in this beautiful name, O you who believe, O believers. This is the best kind of description that a person really would have, this kind of honor and privilege, which is to be among the believers and Allah testifies to them as believers. O you who believe. And the scholars of tafsir, of the explanation of the Qur'an, they say, whenever you hear this statement in the Qur'an, O you who believe, always listen carefully, hearken, because it is something that you are advised, it's a command that you are given, or a prohibition, so that you follow it. This is a beautiful thing that we can benefit from in the Qur'an. Allah says to us, obey Allah and His Messenger, and do not turn away from them while you are listening. So this is the first wisdom that we can take. It's a light. It is the source of light, that we obey Allah and we obey His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because real life, real light and success is in following Allah and His Messenger. Now, how do we follow Allah? How do we obey Allah? Is by reading the Quran and abiding by what is in it. We obey Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is by following his Sunnah, this wonderful treasure that he left for us. As he said, Prophet Muhammad said, I left with you two things after my death. If you hold on to them, if you cling to them, you will never go astray. The Book of Allah and my Sunnah, the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad, his way. So we have these treasures, we'll try to utilize them and benefit from them. So this is the first wisdom that we can take. Obey Allah and His Messenger, obey them. That's the door to success. This is the treasure that you are given. Obey them. This is the course of life that the Muslim should follow. So inshallah, we will take this first wisdom and apply it on our lives. Then Allah says, do not be like those who said, we hear. Okay, but actually they did not really hear. They did not accept it. They did not take it inside. It went in through one ear and then it left through the other. This is the example of so many people, so many Muslims. They say, we are Muslims, we pray, we do follow the Sunnah, we are practicing Muslims, but straight away they go into riba, usury, or evil things. They buy or they sell what is forbidden, what is haram. They do different acts that really incur the anger of Allah. Now these people, even if they say, we hear, but actually they did not really listen, they did not hear. Because these things, these instructions, these teachings of the Qur'an and the Sunnah did not go into their hearts, they did not reflect on their actions. So this is what Allah, when Allah says to us, follow or abide or obey Allah and His Messenger, it means that we should listen and then we take this inside and we understand it and then we abide by it. Then Allah says that the worst kind of creatures, the worst kind of beings are the ones who are deaf, and who cannot even say the truth. They are deaf, they don't hear the truth, they don't listen to it, even if they listen to it physically, but actually they do not follow it. It meant they did not listen to it. And they are the ones who cannot even speak the truth, because if you want to say the truth, you have to listen first. You take the truth from the Quran and the Sunnah, then it will show, as I said, in your actions and on your speech. Then Allah says that if Allah really knew that there was good inside the hearts, He would have made them listen. But because Allah knows their reality, Allah caused them to be deaf to the truth. They don't hear it. They don't really take it inside. Then Allah gives another wisdom, another instruction that is very important to us, that He says, O you who believe, answer the call of Allah and His Messenger. Answer their call. When they call you, come to them. Answer their call. Then He says, if they call you to that which brings you life. Allah and His Messenger call us to the Qur'an and the Sunnah, to this wonderful religion, to the light of the Qur'an. And Allah says that it gives you life. What Allah calls us to, what the Prophet ﷺ calls us to, this gives us life, real life, the life of the heart, the real life that we should be looking for. So Obedience to Allah, this shows that obedience to Allah, if someone feels that his heart has hardened, they do not benefit from the Quran and the Sunnah, that it shows the way to soften your heart, which is to always, whenever Allah tells you to do something, do it. When Allah prohibits you from something, straight away abstain from it, stop doing it, and keep away from it. Likewise, when Prophet Muhammad tells you to do something, you do it without question. Don't say, what's the wisdom behind this? What's the wisdom behind that? No, we are Muslims. Allah said, استجيبوا, listen or answer the call of Allah and His Messenger. When they tell you something, straight away follow it, abide by it. So by this you give light to, you give life and light to your heart. So Allah says, whenever Allah and His Messenger call you to that which gives you life, then answer. Answer the call of Allah and His Messenger, then Allah says, gives a very clear warning, which is very important for us to learn. He says, and be sure that Allah can stand between someone and his heart. You see, if you don't answer the call of Allah and His Messenger, it means that Allah will split. Allah will stand between you and your heart, and you will have no control over it. So many people say, I don't want to be practicing now. When I grow older, I can start practicing. I don't need to pray now as I'm very young. Then in the future, when I become 40, 50 years old, I will be practicing. Who told you that you can be practicing at that age? Because if you keep turning away from the call of Allah and His Messenger, Allah will stand between you and your heart. So you have no control on your heart. You will lose your heart and you might lose it forever. So whenever you hear something from Allah and His Messenger, straight away abide by it, full-heartedly, happily, with contentment, with strength of the faith, with the warmth of belief. So you become, Allah will give you more control over your heart, so you can soften your heart and give it more light and life from the Quran. Then Allah gives a very important warning. Allah says, and protect yourselves from a trial, from a fitna, trial, that if it falls, it will not only reach the evil ones, but it will become very common. It will reach everyone. And this is a lesson that we should learn. You know, whenever a trial comes, whenever an evil befalls people, the people who do sin, it actually reaches everyone, the sinners and the righteous people. And this is one of the rules that Allah set in this world. When a trial, when an affliction or a punishment falls, it reaches the righteous and it reaches the sinners. It reaches the believers and the non-believers. Then Allah will deal with everyone according to their intention. But this is the problem with fitna. So when you see that there is some kind of trial, some evil spreading in your community, in your society, it means if you don't try to stop it, it will come to you. It will come to your house, maybe to your wife, to your husband, to your daughter, to your son, to your brother, your sister. And if punishment comes, it will befall everyone. That's the problem. This is why the Muslim should always give advice. Why? To protect the community from evil becoming spread, widespread, so it reaches everyone and the evil of it comes to everyone. Then Allah concludes these instructions by saying that the Muslims should not be treacherous. Do not betray others. This is not the attitude of the Muslim. Don't betray Allah and His Messenger or other people. Then Allah says, if you fear Allah and follow these, Allah will give you the criterion, which is the light that we are trying to get, the light that we are seeking. If you fear Allah, follow the instructions of Allah, Allah will give you the criterion, Allah will give you the light, and this is the gift that Allah gives the righteous ones, the true believers. We ask Allah to give us this light, the criterion to recognize what is good from what is evil, and have more knowledge about ourselves, about our religion, and about this life, and about our end, inshallah, with Allah. Until we meet next time, with another wisdom, another light from the Quran, I leave you in peace. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Guided us by the Quran.